Direct to
Hollywood traffic, Cherokee 1,
database. Where are we going?
Orcas Island. Wasn't it Coors?
Oh, what was it?
Coors, wasn't it? AORS.
Yeah. Nation.
I should start flying.
You should. Okay, so before takeoff, canopy down, harness, are you all buckled in?
Yep.
Instruments, we got direct to Orcas in there.
Traffic,
we got the that set up. Master switches are all on. Oil pressure and oil pressure. Temperatures are good. Radios are set. Autopilot is off. Prop is full forward. We're going to go full forward trim.
And the fuel pressure is like borderline low. Is that normal?
Yeah, just because we're sitting here at idle.
Okay.
You're keyed into that oil or fuel pressure now.
Yep.
Sure. Okay, trim is set, flaps coming to 10. Controls, watch yourself.
There's traffic sky, 6420 is on the left down with 3-4.
Three correct, runway, we're going to turn the landing
approach on 3-4 in sight.
Transponder, time noted. Okay, you ready?
Yep.
Okay, now we're going to figure out where everybody's at.
There's one coming now. There's another one over there.
Arlington traffic, Legacy 16 Delta, X-ray departing runway 3-4, straight out to the north, Arlington.
Hey, Boo Boo Bear. That'll be on the camera.
Okay.
Ready?
Yep.
Traffic, Legacy 16 Delta X-ray, clear the pattern to the north.
Distance, 42 miles.
That's not bad at all. I'm so glad I have you as a chauffeur.
Yeah, kind of works out.
It would have taken me like a 12-hour round trip to get out here today.
Yeah, that would have been a pain. So, YouTube. The Bean had a property to go look at for her work that's out on Orcas Island, and it just so happened to be right on the airport. By the way, keep looking for traffic while we're in.
Okay.
We've gone out there. Was that last year or 2 years ago?
A couple years ago.
2 years ago to look at the same property for a client. And it was a ferry ride, a car ride, lunch. I mean, it was a full day to go out there and back. And our same client called back and said, I need you to go inspect this place again. We were like, hey, we got an airplane now.
Yes.
And the property is right on the airport. It's a hangar that she's going to look at. So, we're going to save her a bunch of time.
Arlington traffic, 128 Romeo, Romeo, train left cross.
Time is money.
Southbound departure, 29 Arlington.
By taking the Legacy out here.
Yeah.
It's 42 miles away. We're going to see how quickly we can. So this is going to work. We were going to go yesterday. In fact, we were in the car, headed to the airport. And this is kind of funny as I kind of familiarize myself with the runways and the traffic pattern since I screwed up Friday Harbor the other day and went in left traffic when I was a right traffic runway. Thanks, whoever caught that and called me out on it, because I knew I did it. But anyway, I don't know how I did that, but I did. So, I was familiarizing myself with the runway out there at Orcas, which is where we're headed, and I pull up the runway to see what the traffic pattern is, and it says runway closed. I'm like, what? So I pulled up the NOTAMs, and lo and behold, the airport was closed. So I called the port, and I got they're doing something during the daytime from 8 to 4, so anytime after 4, so here we are after 4 p.m. the next day.
Northbound, climbing to the 2500, and go to the 108.
Headed out to Orcas. Hey, do you want to fly?
No.
Yeah, you're going to help me out here. You got
to
learn this.
I don't want to do it.
Just grab the stick and keep the wings level. That's all you got to do. And keep it a little better. So it's just with your fingertips. There you go, just like that. Just with your fingertips. That's all you're doing. You're just helping me out so I can get down to four flight. Okay, ready for me to take you back?
Yeah.
Okay, good job.
Okay, thanks.
Do you know where exactly? It's right on the other side of that highest point, right? There, because there's that tower. I think the runways are right over there.
I can't see anything besides this.
You can't see over the dash at all? All right, well, we're going to level
off. My level's like right here.
We're going to level off here at 6,500.
So pretty out tonight.
Yeah. It really is. I hope our GoPro's still on the tail.
Don't say that.
All right, I'm going to start a decent. I'm pretty sure it's right on the. See that? Can you see now? I'm going to drop the nose a little
bit.
Yeah. It's right on the other side of that. Or is it in that harbor that's past there? I'm not that familiar with it.
The island looks like two, like, lungs, and then the runway's in the middle.
Yeah. Flaps are 40, there we go. Look at that, on and on start. A little smaller runway, huh?
Yeah, looks like we're gonna go in the water.
I didn't want to float that. Easy peasy. Okay, turn those off. Open the, pop the canopy. Yeah, get some air. Flaps. Got the flap lever coming up. The reason, you know, the reason that I say that and touch it and before I move anything?
Huh.
Because people have accidentally raised the gear,
oh,
clearing the runway. Hey, flaps up, and they go, psh, that looks like a wheel, that looks like a wing, so that's your flap. So I always touch stuff, think about it, that's the one I want. Okay, up.
Smart.
There's a saying, no fast hands in the cockpit. You don't get bonus points for doing all your stuff as fast as you can. You're
in a plane?
Not.
You're going to park right next to a car. By the way, you have to edit all this address stuff out. Perfect.
Orcas Island traffic, Legacy 16 Delta X-ray, departing runway 34, Orcas Island.
Birds.
Red Air for traffic, Skyhawk 8953 Tango, Orcas Ferry Dock 1600 descending, point caution, we're straight at 16, traffic permitting, Red Air.
Fly over this little rock.
Orcas Island traffic, Lake 216 South X-ray, clear to the northeast, Orcas Island.
There's that lake that we boated on that one day.
STD or the mini boat?
The STD. We're gonna go circling.
Not like sharp circles though. I didn't take any Dramamine and you're gonna make me throw up in your plane. And then it will smell like barf forever.
Okay.
Just letting you know. There's consequences.
I'm just gonna
do it. There will be consequences.
How sharp can I do?
Not like the other day when you thought you were gonna dog.
See how smooth, see how smooth that is right there?
Yeah.
Is that all right?
Yeah.
Or no?
I just don't like the hard G's.
So it's not the angle bank that you're not liking. It's the...
It's the G's on my tummy.
Okay, no G's on the tummy. Noted. Oh, there's Skagit Speedway. Let's go check that out.
Oh, I see.
Checking bank without pulling. I don't think you like the pulling because it messes up the fluid in your ears, but I'm not pulling right now, right?
Yeah.
So it doesn't feel that bad to you, or no? Just being in an angle of bank?
Not so bad.
Okay. I'm just trying to figure out what works for you, what doesn't. All right,
traffic, tail check 5360, Lima, 3 miles to the south. 3 miles to the south on the localizer 34.
I'll give you a wing rock so you can see the. It's going to be out your side here in just a second. Ready?
Okay. I see it.
Oh, I screwed that up. Okay, I bet you saw it.
I saw.
Glen Valley traffic, 6712 Golf Hotel, Golf Oscar Whiskey Hotel, over Maple Ridge at 2,500 feet, eastbound.
Did you understand a word that guy just said?
Nope.
Sound like he had peanut butter in his mouth.
So how come last time when we left the airport, as soon as we got up in the air, you were like talking to everybody and everything. This time you're like, I'm not going to talk to anybody.
Because there was nobody around Orcas Island. I heard the guys over at Friday Harbor. That's not a concern. Because there's not very much traffic out there compared to Arlington. That's why I want to broadcast to everybody there with kind of the hopes of somebody else identifying themselves too if they're in the area. So it just kind of goes off of where you're at, where how much traffic there is or isn't.
Arlington traffic, Legacy 16 Delta X-ray, 10 miles to the northeast, 3,000 descending for, we'll maneuver inner air right downwind for 3-4, full stop, Arlington.
Wait, 3-4 is left downwind. Why am I getting everything mixed up?
You've had a long day.
Yeah. I'm struggling. So we're set up perfect in our 45 for 3-4. Never mind. Not with it today. Maybe I better start slowing down now.
Are you going to hit the speed brakes?
No.
Okay, good.
Trying not to. You didn't like that.
That was aggressive.
Super aggressive.
Arlington traffic, Legacy 16 Delta X-ray on a 45 to enter a left downwind for 3-4, full stop, Arlington. Arlington traffic, Legacy 16 Delta X-ray, turning left base, full stop, 3-4, Arlington.
Gear, got 1-2-3 down locked. Trim, W's down, and the flaps to come, and I hand it. I got wide, wasn't paying attention. Belly check, nobody coming in final, yep.
Arlington traffic, Legacy 16 Delta X-ray turning final 3-4, full stop, Arlington.
Oh, nice overshoot, Eric. Good lord, I'm not on my A game today. I'll call that out right now. Okay, I got flaps 40, I got that gears down 3 green, and let's see what. Let's just call it a day. Good lord. Oh my god. Can we just call it a day?
Arlington traffic, Commander 114 Bravo Mike on the 45 for runway 34, left traffic, Arlington.
You just want to go home now? Please.
We were only gone like 1.2 Zulu hours.
1.2 Zulu. Alright, flap handle. So that's for non-aviation enthusiasts watching the channel. This brought up a, Tina just brought up a, I mean the bean. The bean dip just brought up a point that I kind of assumed people would know, but I guess if you're not in the aviation world, you wouldn't know, is when we were going to go to Orcas yesterday and we pulled up the NOTAM, which is a notice to air, and currently known as notice to air missions, to be gender neutral. Yes, that's the FAA did that. It used to be notice to airmen. Now it's notice to air missions. Anyway, I digress. So I was trying to figure out the times, and it was like 1500 to 2300, and I didn't know if that was Zulu or if that was local time zone, because I wasn't that familiar with four flight on the times of that thing works on. And so when I said to Tina, I'm like, I don't know if the runway's open right now, because I don't know if this is local time or Zulu time. And she says, what's Zulu time? You'd never heard of that. So Zulu time, or GMT, or Greenwich Mean Time, is the entire aviation world is based on. Everything is weather forecast. Everything goes off of Zulu time, which is essentially the time in England, which is, I want to say it's the prime meridian, whatever, 0 degrees of longitude is ground zero in the aviation world. So whatever time zone London, England is, or Greenwich, England, actually, that is Zulu time. And it will usually say, like, 1500Z to 2300Z, so you know that it's referencing Zulu, but almost all of aviation goes off of that one time zone, so there's no confusion. Everybody's on the same sheet. In fact, the clock in the Boeing, it's on Zulu times. So you know, so it's, you always know.
Well, if you made it this far through the video, thanks for watching it. I hope you enjoyed it. I just wanted to take a minute to talk about fatigue. This, when I'm doing these videos, sometimes I'm just, hey, we're going out to Orcas and back. And I can see as I'm editing them, there's a very valuable point in here. And this one was all about fatigue. I saw myself making mistakes going into Orcas Island. I kept wanting to call it Friday Harbor for whatever reason. That was my first clue to myself. And I picked up on that. I knew I wasn't sharp. My landing in Orcas was a little bit firm. I just knew that I wasn't on my A game. Coming back into Arlington, I want to say that I called it runway 16, not 34. I picked up on that. That's when I said, all right, I need to slow it down. So I slowed down my comms. That's how you kind of, you identifying the fact that you are fatigued is the first step. Then kind of combating it is the second step. So I slowed it down with my comms. Make sure I got the right thing out of my mouth so I didn't instill confusion in everybody else listening to the radio. And then checklist, checklist, checklist. If you're relying on flows and just your experience and memory, and you know that you're fatigued, grab that checklist, the actual paper checklist, pick it up and make sure you're doing those items. Those things will save you in those cases when you're tired and you're just not thinking right. You're just not, you know, on your A game. So anyway, I just take a quick note to mention that as I was doing this video, I'm like, there's a lesson learned here, and that's recognizing and how I personally have learned over the years to combat the fatigue. So thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed the video. We'll catch you next time.